To be very precise, up until end of the 19th century, even in America, medical treatment was so good, they had modern medicine so called. They called it allopathy. What is allopathy? Everything is allopathy except homeopathy. Allo is against, pathy is disease. Homeopathy is homeopathy. It's for the body. Again, body only cures. Now, 1899, up until that time, there was so-called allopathy. Ayurveda was not there, but herbal medicine was there. Herbal medicine was a very big rage in America. Chiropractic came in about 1900. Homeopathy. Then radioesthesia, which was using electric current to treat patients. And shaman medicine. Then pranic healing, reiki, acupuncture, and what have you. Chinese medicine, Tibetan medicine, everything. And equally respected. Then in 1899 to be precise, this D.P. Palmer, he was a medical doctor, he was an MD, thought, and rightly so, that most of the problems are due to the spinal nerves and the brain and the spinal cord. And he said, if you set all the muscles right, you will get treated. So he called it chiropractic. So it became a science also. But 1900, America discovered oil. Oil means money. So they thought, we can exploit the world of oil, fooling the Arabs, and then make money and enjoy life. And their own money, we will probably buy that for $10 a barrel and send them mineral water for $100 a barrel and make money. So at this time, three players were there, three very eminent players. John Rockefeller, Andrew Carnegie, and D.P. Morgan. These were in different business, competing with one another. Then they realized, with this new thing coming up, we can all join together, collaborate, help each other, and cheat the world. That's how money, big money is made, by collaborating and cheating the world. What did they do? There were 147 medical schools in America. They were teaching various things. 47 of them were teaching what is called allopathy. They were all funded by Carnegie Mellon Foundation and Rockefeller Foundation and D.P. Morgan's. Now, other 100 medical colleges were teaching various things. Herbal medicine. There are a lot of herbal medical colleges. Acupuncture, Ayurveda, Chinese medicine. Ayurveda was not there. Chinese medicine, etc., etc. So they influenced the president of the country, gave him a lot of money, and told him, we will have a one-man commission to inspect the medical colleges and say which are scientific and which are non-scientific. What is the definition of science? There was no definition of science. Anyway, who did they appoint? Man called Benjamin Flexner. No, Andrew Flexner. What was he? He was the headmaster of a school in the Carnegie Mellon Foundation. Retired. Now a headmaster of a school who doesn't know what medicine is becomes a one-man commission to inspect medical colleges and decide. Like our MCA. Many of the people in the MCA don't know what medical education is. But they are there. Some good people leave it and come out. But others hang on and destroy medical education in this country. But anyway, now this fellow inspects 147 medical colleges in 6 months and writes a report saying that 47 medical colleges which are using the reductionist pharmaceutical chemistry are the only scientific ones, the other ones are unscientific. These 47 medical colleges ran on Andrew Carnegie Mellon Foundation. Did you understand that? So, with the stroke of the pen, the other medical colleges are closed and America became scientific medicine in America. And the other colleges were all called unscientific and they were not allowed to practice. And whatever happens in America, Britain copies them. And Britain also same order came, but the British royal family lived on homeopathy. So the king said no. And the queen also said no. And homeopathy is still alive in Britain, but now there is a concerted effort to kill homeopathy in Britain. If any one of you is in the habit of reading English dailies, there's a paper called Guardian. On Tuesday, normally you get a large full page cover by a young doctor called Goldacre. Goldacre is a young doctor who is financed by the pharmaceutical companies very heavily and is a good writer. He writes such convincing articles every day that homeopathy is dead and don't believe in it. In fact, modern scientific data in quantum physics shows homeopathy is much more scientific than modern medicine. So homeopathy believes in energy treatment.